Hi, I'm Russ Klein, CEO of the American Marketing Association, and I have the privilege of being here today with Gareth Davies, the CEO and founder of AdBrain, and also recipient of the AMA's 4 Under 40 Award. Good to be with you, Gareth.
Wonderful to be here, Russ. Thank you.
Gareth, I'm looking at the future right now, the future of marketing. But what would you say to others in terms of how you characterize the future of marketing, and what would you recommend to other emerging leaders who are stepping into that future?
Yeah, that's a great question. I mean, I think if I can summarize it in one word, I would say the future of marketing is intelligence. I think there's a wealth of opportunities for marketers to have a better understanding of their customers through data. And I think traditionally that has seemed scary or challenging, or there's been impediments to get access to a marketer's core customer data. But really, marketers have been foundationally using data since the advent of modern marketing. So I think we're going to see really exciting advancements in the way marketers own and control their data and have more complete and cohesive views of their customer. And that's going to allow much more engaging and really, you know, one-to-one experiences at scale, which until now has still eluded us, I think.
One of the issues that I see come up over and over again for marketers is getting a single view of the customer, both in terms of data as well as understanding their behavior and being able to measure the impact of various forms of media across the customer journey. And AdBrain has solutions that allow you to measure effective reach and frequency across an omni-channel world. That's a huge solution. Tell people about that.
Yeah, thank you. So, I mean, that's really the foundation of our business. Our job is to help marketers have a clear and single view of their consumer across all connected devices. I think as we're seeing, the shift to mobile has gone pretty aggressively since the advent of the smartphone. We're now seeing much greater connected TV adoption in the household, as well as the connected car and the connected home really starting to come into fruition, you know, whether that's Amazon Alexa or Google devices. So I think what's exciting and is an opportunity for the marketer is to really help piece together this customer journey. It comes with its challenges, because trying to understand who a user is without a singular login or without owning and operating media touch points across every single device creates complexity. So that's really why AdBrain was founded. We use machine learning and lots of data to effectively deduce that a single user is the same person across all their connected devices, and do that in a very scalable and privacy safe manner, and then make that easy and plugged into the marketer's software partners of choice, whether that's their ad server or their analytics software or their demand side platform. Our job is to make it really easy for them to build that customer profile and then to activate on it and ultimately analyze exposure and reach and frequency and control frequency capping. So there's a wonderful array of opportunities, but it all starts with getting that singular view to start with.
As a head of the American Marketing Association myself, I have to follow on and ask you, how long does it take for a marketer to go from zero to that future state that you've just described?
I think we're all on a journey, Russ, all of us. So I don't believe, and I would caution against believing your agency or software partners if they say that end state is just, you know, a step away. I think it's incumbent upon all of us as marketers and as practitioners to equip ourselves with the tools to get there. And I think that's a mixture of knowledge and participation, such as being here today, for example, alongside working with the right consultants and agency partners and software providers. So I think the answer is that it depends on the priorities of the marketer. But, you know, we're in an exciting time where those tools and the opportunities exist.
All right, so you mentioned machine learning.
Yep.
Between automation's steady march towards a digital world and artificial intelligence, these things started out doing the dangerous and the dirty, then doing the dull, and now doing the decision-making.
Yeah.
What does a future state driven by AI mean for marketers, and should marketers be excited about it or worried about it?
Yeah, I suppose I'll answer it in two ways. I think humanity, you know, we should all be excited about the opportunity to automate and become more precise in some of the you know, either key business decisions or life decisions we make, as well as automate some of the mundane and level us up as humans to be better in our craft and our art. I think there's a lot of hype around artificial intelligence and a lack of understanding. We're a long way away from strong AI, where you have cognitive, self-thinking, emotionally aware machines, a very long way away. Where we are today is huge acceleration in the amount of data available, and much better systems that can predict what consumers want or need. A great example is Google Now. You know, I have it on my Android device. It predicts where I'm going to be next, what I'm likely to, you know, want to purchase, or what the weather's going to be. These are still very small edge case examples. The opportunity for marketers is to basically start sorting through the masses of data that they're collecting across all their digital channels, from search, display, video, you know, offline data and CRM. You know, how do I to email? How do I tie all of this together and to ultimately better understand the customer and then make better decisions? So I think you're seeing large-scale enterprise companies like Salesforce and others make really big advancements here, and companies like ourselves focus on very specific problems that really help accelerate that. So I'm pretty excited. I think it frees all of us up to solve bigger and more meaningful problems, which lead to a better customer experience, and hopefully a more efficient marketing mix, and, you know, fewer wasted ads, and all these problems about ad fraud and other issues start to fall by the wayside, and we get to a much more value-adding relationship with the consumer, which is what we're all here to do.
Well, on the whole, that sounds like a much brighter future then. Yeah. You've accomplished, Gareth, so much already in your young career. How do you now define career achievement? And is it different than what you once thought of as career achievement?
Yeah, that's a great question. I mean, at a very personal level, it's always about growth, about personal growth and business growth, and is the team growing, and are we achieving what we set ourselves? So again, I feel like I'm on a never-ending journey, and I'm excited about that. I'm thrilled to receive the award today and recognition of what we've collectively, I take it on behalf of my team. You know, we've spent 5 years building a world-class team and a world-class product. And, you know, my job is to get people excited about that vision. I believe that, you know, from a career perspective, we should focus on what we're passionate about. And then that energy attracts others. And if you're solving really large, meaningful problems, ultimately good things will happen. So it's, you know, it's very much a journey for me, but I'm excited. So.
Well, it's been a great honor to spend time with you this morning. Gareth Davies, the CEO and founder of AdBrain, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you so much, Rob.
I'm Russ Kline with the AMA.